In the last session, we discussed about the dividing the polynomials and the remainder theorem. Again, what the remainder theorem says here, if you are dividing the polynomial with the linear polynomial, which is x minus a, and the remainder is always in the form of p of a. This is the remainder theorem states here. That means, without doing the actual division, you can find the remainder of the given polynomial by using the remainder theorem. So here, if you want to find, let us consider one example given here, x squared plus 1 divided by x minus 1. If you want to find the remainder of this one, according to the remainder theorem, what will be the remainder? Which is nothing but p of a is the remainder. In this case, what is the a value here? If you compare these two, what is the a value here? 1. So, what will be the remainder? Which is nothing but the p of 1 is the remainder. So, if p of 1 is the remainder, just if according to the remainder theorem, you can substitute in place of x1 to the dividend so that you will get the remainder. So, we are substituting here. What is the divisor? Which is x squared plus 1. If you substitute in place of x1, you are getting which is 2. This is like this, you can find the remainder. Let us take one more example to find the remainder by using the remainder theorem. Here, let us consider here x squared plus 2x plus 1. If you want to divide this polynomial with x plus 1, without doing the actual division, how do you find it? Now here, you have to see here x minus a, here x plus 1 is there. What will be the remainder? P of a. If it is, if the, what we can say, if the divisor is in the form of x minus a, you can see that the remainder is P of a. But here, the divisor is not in the form of x minus a. You can write this one as x minus of minus 1. Because you know that minus into minus is plus. So now you can compare it here. Here x minus a is there, here x minus of minus 1 is there. So what is the a value here? Which is minus 1. So what you are getting here? The remainder which is p of minus 1. So in place of x, you need to substitute here minus 1. So substitute here, what you will get? Minus 1 whole square plus 2 into minus 1 plus 1. What is the minus 1 whole square? Which is minus 1 plus 2 plus 1. You are getting the remainder which is 0. Like that, you can find, if you are dividing two polynomials, if you want to find the remainder, you can find like this, or otherwise you can find the divisor of the zero of the divisor. Here consider the same example here. If you want to divide here, x squared plus 2x plus 1 divided by x plus 1. If you want to find the remainder, what we need to do, just you need to find the zero of the divisor. How do you find the zero of the divisor? We already discussed before exercises. If you want to find the zero of the polynomial, how do you find? Just you need to equate this value to zero. Or otherwise, which value you need to keep it here so that you are getting the result as zero. In any of the ways you can find it. The easier way is nothing but just equate this polynomial to zero. If you are equating this polynomial to zero, what you are getting? X, y, you are getting as minus 1. Now, you know the zero of the divisor. Just this, put this minus 1 in this one. So what you get here? Minus 1 whole square plus 2 into minus 1 plus 1. You will get the same answer before what we have done. Like this you can find if you want to find the remainder. Let us consider one more example here. Consider x squared plus 4 divided by x plus 1. If you want to find the remainder, what is the first step? You need to find the zero of the divisor. That means if you want to find the zero of the divisor, you need to equate this polynomial to zero. Let us equate this one. You are getting the x value as minus 1. Just substitute minus 1 to the dividend. What you will get here? Minus 1 whole square plus 4. You are getting the result as 5. This is the remainder. Again, consider one more example before going to the exercise. Consider one more example. Let us consider x squared plus 3x plus 5. If you are dividing this polynomial with x plus 1. So, what is the first step? You need to find the 0 of the divisor. If you want to find the 0 of the divisor, equate the polynomial to 0 so that you will get the value of x, which is minus 1. Just substitute this minus 1 in the dividend. If you are substituting minus 1, what you get here? Minus 1 whole square plus 3 into minus 1 plus 5. This is 1 minus 3 plus 5, which is 6 minus 3. You are getting the remainder as 3. Like that, you can find the remainder if you have given 2 points. columns without doing the actual division. Now, see the next exercise. Based on the remainder given, you need to find the remainder without doing the actual division. So, the next text is the first question. X is 2.3. In that the first question, what the given column is here? We have given the column which is 3x³ + 3x² + 3x + 1. Now here in that the first question they have given x plus 1. Here so many polynomials are given here. They said that if you are dividing this polynomial with this polynomial, what will be the remainder? What the question asked here? If you are dividing this polynomial, what will be the remainder? You need to find by using the remainder theorem without doing the actual division. So here, if you want to divide these two polynomials with the remainder theorem, first you need to find the divisor of this one. So write it here. Now, 0 of the divisor, the 0 of the polynomial of divisor, what's the divisor x + 1 is, what will be the 0 of the polynomial of the divisor, which is nothing but x + 1 = 0. You are getting the x by plus minus 1. Now write it here, replace x by minus 1 in the dividend. If you are replacing minus 1 in the dividend, what you will get? Just in place of x, substitute minus 1. What you will get here? -1² + 3 × -1² + 3 × -1 + 1. Now solve this one. What you get? -1³. That means you need to multiply -1 3 times. So, you know that -1 × -1 which is 1. 1 × -1 which is minus 1. So, write it here -1. And after that, -1² which is 1. 3 × 1 which is 3. Similarly here -3 + 1. Here, you know that 3 − 3 = 0. -1 + 1 = 0. So, you are getting the remainder as 0 without doing the actual division. Now, see the second question here. x − 1/2. This question is your homework. You can do it in the same way. The homework in the first question, second way. Now, let's see the third one in that. They have given the polynomial x. Here, the third question, what they have given here, you need to divide these two polynomials without doing the actual division. So, what is the first step? You need to find the 0 of the polynomial of the divisor. So, here, what is the divisor in this case? Which is x. Right? So, you can write what is the divisor of x. If you want to find the divisor of the x, you need to equate this value to 0. So, let us equate this value to 0. So, you are getting the x value as 0. Now, replace x by 0 in the divisor. Now, in place of x, put 0. So, what you get here? 0³ + 3 × 0² + 3 × 0 + 1. You know that all these will become 0. So, what will be the remainder? Which is 1. Now, see the next question. They have given x + 5. The fourth question is that they have given x + 5. If you want to divide this polynomial with the x + 5, what will be the remainder? Similarly here, first you need to find the 0 of the polynomial of the divisor. What is the divisor in this case? Which is x + 5. If you want to find the divisor, you need to equate that polynomial to 0. So just equate it, x + 5 = 0. Then what is the value of x? Which is -5. If you take +5 to the side, it will become -5. Now what we need to do? Just you need to replace x by -5. So write it here. If you replace that one, what you get here? -5³ + 3 × -5² + 3 × 5 + 1. So what will be the remainder here? -5³ + 3 pi² + 3 pi + 1. This is the remainder if you are dividing these two polynomials. Now, see the last one, they have given 5 plus 2x. फ्रंट में 5 + 2x. इफ यू आर डिवाइडिंग दिस पॉलीनोमियल विद दिस पॉलीनोमियल, व्हाट विल बी द रिमाइंडर? व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप? यू नीड टू फाइंड द जीरो ऑफ द पॉलीनोमियल ऑफ द डिवाइजर. इन दिस केस व्हाट इज द डिवाइजर? 5 + 2x. सो राइट हियर 5 + 2x. जस्ट कीप इट दैट पॉलीनोमियल टू जीरो. सो व्हाट इज इट हियर? 5 + 2x इज इक्वल टू जीरो. इन दिस केस यू नीड टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ द x. सो हियर 2x इज इक्वल टू, इफ यू टेक प्लस 5 टू दैट साइड, इट विल बिकम -5. Now what is the value of x? -5. Since we are multiplying, if you take to that side, it will become division. You will take -5/2. Now in place of x, what we need to be? -5/2. So write it here. Replace x by -5/2. If you are keeping -5/2, what you will get here? Check it just here. -5/2 whole cube + 3 × -5/2 whole square + 3 × 5/2 + 1. Just you need to solve this one. How do you solve? Just solve it here. -5/2 whole cube is nothing but you need to multiply 5/2 three times. You know that 5 × 5 is 25. 25 × 5 is 125. You will get here 125. By what is the value of 2 cube? 2 × 2 which is 4. 4 × 2 is 8. So you get here 8. You will get minus symbol. You know that -×-is + +×-is-. So what is the value of 5/2 whole square, which is nothing but 25/4. So you get here 3 × 25/4. And after that here, what you get here? -5/2. So here -15. You know that +×-is - 3 × 5 is 15. So you get here -15/2 + 1. Now you need to solve that one. So what we get here, which is 125/8 + 3 × 25/4, and after that +×-is - 3 × 5 is 15/2 + 1. Now here you can observe that what you get here, -125/8 + what is the value of 25 × 3, which is nothing but 75. So write it here 75/4 - 15/2 + 1. Now you can take the LCM, and after solving this one you will get the answer. Now see the next question, which is the second question. So if you have given any polynomial, just you need to find the divisor of the zero of the divisor of the polynomial. Just equate that value to the given polynomial so that you will get the remainder. Now see the second question here. Find the remainder. Just they have given the polynomial. What they have given? The given polynomial is x³ - px² + 6x - p. And what they have given here is divided by the polynomial, which is x - p. If you are dividing this polynomial with x - p, what will be the remainder? You need to find by using the remainder theorem. If you want to find by using the remainder theorem, what is the first step? You need to find the zero of the divisor. So write it here. The zero of the polynomial of divisor. What is the divisor in this case? Which is x - p is. If you want to find the divisor, just equate to that to zero. So what is the value of xp? Just replace that the value of x in the dividend. So replace x by p. What you get in place of x, if you keep p, what you get? p³ - p×p² + 16 × p - p. Just in place of x, we have kept here p. So what you get here? p³ - p×p², which is nothing but p cube. And after that 6p - p. You know that p³ will get cancelled. You will get here 6p - p, which is nothing but 5p. This is the problem. Now here, see the third question. This third question, you can do it as a homework. I will explain how to solve this question here. What is the third question given here? Find the remainder when 2x² - 3x minus 3. Does it exactly divide the polynomial? State the reason. This is the question they have given. They asked to divide these two polynomials and they asked whether it divides exactly or not. What is meant by divides exactly is nothing but if you are getting the remainder as 0, we can say that this polynomial divides this polynomial exactly, otherwise it is not. That means you need to find the remainder as 0. If it is 0, we can say that it divides exactly, otherwise it is not. Now, you need to find the remainder by using the remainder theorem. If you want to find the remainder, what is the first step? You need to find the 0 of the divisor. If you want to find the 0 of the polynomial of the divisor, consider 2x minus 3, you know that it is the divisor, equate this to 0. From this, you need to find the value of x. You know that the value of x is 3 by 2. Now, just substitute 3 by 2 in this equation. So, what you get? 2 into 3 by 2 whole square minus 3 into 3 by 2 plus 5. If you solve this one, you will get some answer. If you are getting 0, you can say that it divides exactly. But if you are getting the remainder not 0, you can say that it does not divide exactly. This is our question homework. Now see the fourth question. Here, what is the given polynomial here?
The remainder
by using the remainder theorem. From this session is completed. In the next session, we are going to solve the remaining problems of this exercise.